Welcome to week 6 of the Junior Grand Prix 2018. I'm your host, Ted Barton, and this week we're in one of the most beautiful little cities in Europe, Ljubljana. Ljubljana is the capital and largest city in Slovenia. It's home to around 280,000 people and has been the cultural, educational, political, and administrative center of Slovenia since 1991. It has a very clean and natural environment, and although certainly a tourist attraction, what is most notable is that traditional life goes around you each day, at the same time welcoming everyone who visits this magical place. When I'm here, it's like you're in a dream. It's very special indeed. Two more Junior Grand Prix are left, and points for the Junior Grand Prix final are hard to come by. The pairs have finished the series, and five Russian and one American team have qualified. In dance, Elizaveta Kuda-Beradieva and Nikita Nazarov of Russia and Marjorie Lajoie and Zachary Laga of Canada have secured their spots, but there are four spots yet still to be determined. In men, two Americans, Camden Polkinen and Andrew Torgashev, appear to have secured tickets to the final, with the other four spots to be decided over the final 2 weeks. In ladies, it seems Aliona Korsunaya and Anna Shcherbakova, both of Russia, and Yilim Kim of Korea have solidified positions for the final, with the battle for the other three spots to unfold here in Ljubljana and next week in Yerevan. It's week 6 of the 2018 Junior Grand Prix. Every jump, every spin really matters if you want a trip to the Vancouver Junior Grand Prix final. The pressure's really on, and it starts right now. Hello everyone, welcome to Ljubljana, Slovenia, day 3 of competition, week 6 of the Junior Grand Prix. I'm your host, Ted Barton. Beautiful shot in downtown, wonderful weather, spectacular city, friendly people, just charming all the way around. Such a pleasure to visit. And a look at the Tivoli Arena, host of the third Junior Grand Prix in the past 5 years. Welcome live inside the building. The ladies' free program about to take to the ice. There'll be six groups, 36 ladies, two ice resurfacing. And it'll start at 12:30 and it'll end at 17:53. Long event indeed, but some very good skating. Countries represented around the world. Remember, we want you to subscribe to the ISU Junior Grand Prix YouTube channel. So if you see an icon, an ISU logo in the bottom right-hand part of your screen, click on that and subscribe. You'll get notifications for uploaded videos and, most importantly, when we go live on a Junior Grand Prix event. Remember, we've got Armenia next week and the Junior Grand Prix final in Vancouver in December. There's a look at the technical panel of judges, officials, and now all the judges.
Representing Slovenia, Anna Schmer.
a look at the start order for the event. Well, we have a long day of skating here. Last night was a very exciting event in the men. Battle all the way, some terrific skating and performances in the last six, actually throughout the event, last two or three groups. But some outstanding performances, efforts made in group number four, final group, everybody fighting for position and unusual results. Tomiki Iwatashi of the United States had a fourth in the short and a fifth in the free, but ended up third overall. Fought his way through that program. And Mark from Israel skated well, but didn't have all the difficult elements. So he dropped down quite a bit, moving Tomoki up. And a look at the start order for group one, just finishing up their warm-up now. And remember to follow us on all the social media platforms, Facebook and Instagram, YouTube, which you're obviously watching here, and the Twitter account for ISU at ISU_figure. And here we go. I was 14 years old, born in Jesenice. First Junior Grand Prix season, coached by Anya and Kaja Otovic. first skater out in a field of 36 here on Saturday morning. Afternoon, skating her free program to Romeo and Juliet, performed by Andrew Ryu. Well, it's never easy skating first, especially early on in the day. In front of your home crowd, she had a pretty good go at it. This triple toe got away from her a little bit too far forward and didn't rotate quick enough. It's got to snap so fast into those multi-rotational jumps. Here's the double axel. This was good. Straight through. Gets the free leg around and gets that double toe loop done. So that's good. Double lutz coming up here. Just too far, let her body go. You got to hold that back up so strong. You feel like you've got a break, but you don't. You need to keep the back strong and the abs. There's the double flip. Loose free leg a little bit. You want to straighten that up. And this swung around the circle, probably a little tired, so changed her approach a bit, her technique a little. Didn't take it straight through like the first one. Here's a double flip. Gets the free leg back, double toe loop. Good work there. And closes out with layback. There's the side position. Grabs the leg, now straight back. Nicely centered. Layback spin level two to finish the program. Good experience here. How to skate under pressure. Expectations for yourself and from others. Always a challenge for young people to deal with at the best of times in life, let alone in sport. Free skating score 54.63. Total competition score 82.70. First skater out. Gemma's 16. This is her second Junior Grand Prix season. She was born in Luxembourg. And skating her free program to Elements, performed by Lindsay Sterling. We'll be right back. Well, Gemma is a very quick rotator, so this is a great asset to have. She turns quickly, and as she moves on into the triple jumps, that's so critical. A little bit more strength, she'll get a little higher, although she has good height on these doubles as well. But we'll take a look at some of that. You'll see how fast and tidy. Look how straight she is in the air. Nice. Look at the arms, right into the body. You don't see any space. Pay particular attention to the arms. Here's the double axel. Arms are back, up, and right in. See how tight they are to the body? Makes her aerodynamical. Same thing with the free leg. Let's watch how tight those legs are. Oh, the triple salto. This didn't work as well. Didn't get up high enough, although the position in the air was good. Second double axel. See how tight the legs are as well? Didn't get all the way around. Arms in tight, legs together. Perfect. Nice and easy rotation in the air. Now, a little bit more speed, a little bit more pop off the ice. She's going to have a great flight pattern, and triple jumps will be soon after that for sure. Nice double flip, double toe. Certainly some polishing to do. A little bit better posture, stretch the hands out, point the toes, although this was nice. All the performance aspect, which that's the polishing of a skater. That takes time once you have the confidence of the technical elements. Feel a little bit more comfortable in reaching out and performing to a higher degree. Phase one, good. Good basic skills here for her jumps. Carry on. Let's move them into three rotations. .59 for Gemma's free program. That's first so far, and an overall score of 85.82. Gemma overall is currently in first early on in the competition. Christina, 18 years old, born in Tallinn. This is her second Junior Grand Prix season. She's coached by Irina Kononova and choreographed by Valentin Molotov. And skating her free program here this afternoon in Ljubljana. Week 6, Junior Grand Prix. Skating to All I Ask of You from The Phantom of the Opera by Andrew Lloyd Webber. Now, this is a very interesting skater, so I'm going to start to speak quickly now. She's really, if you look deeper, you know, she's early on in this event. If you look deeper, wow, she's got some great skills. She's passionate in performance, at least in the beginning. She didn't do that in the end. She's did a beautiful trip of flip, so she can really rotate and jump, but she popped a number of other jumps, and she's an excellent spinner. She has all skills. Now, you need to deliver them in competition. Fair enough. That's what it is. But this young lady is much better than what her placement will show. Let's take a look. Here's the opening moves here. She's feeling this. She's taking her time. You can see the head movement all the way back. There's a little feeling in this. Nice soft edges and soft knees. There, you can see in this facial expression, she's, yeah, beautiful. You won't see that later, but at the beginning, so she can do it. Here is rush. So she pops double and goes for the, and pops double. So that's a timing issue. Not that she can't do it, but look at this. Triple flip, no problem. So if she can do that, she can do all the other jumps triple. Here's the double axel, arms back, snaps in tight, gets around, oiler, not all the way around, but okay, so she's, you can see that she has these skills. Look at this spin, beautiful turned out toe, nicely centered, straight free leg, change the edge to the forward outside. That was nicely done. Good sit spin. So all the basics are there. She has all the qualities in spins and jumps. But here's the end. Some of these moves, you don't see the same passion at this part of the program. Well, she's tired a little bit. That's okay. But there's pretty much nothing that this young lady doesn't have, maybe just not doing it in the competition. So that's really encouraging as she moves forward. She trains hard, gets in the shape that she can keep that energy up. Believe in what you have, young lady. It's very good. You have to look deep to find it, but it's there. .61.23, that's first so far in the free program with a total competition score of 92.13. She has all those elements, she didn't produce them all. Looking forward to seeing that program and content at a later date. Anna, 14 years old, first Junior Grand Prix season. She's coached by Teodora Postek. And she's skating to Coffee with Aliens by Max Lemat. Well, a couple things for Anna, of course, skating in front of her fans and her colleagues and club mates. Always a challenge because you want to do so well, push a little harder. But a couple things, rotation position in the air, absolutely critical. I talk about that all the time because it is the main thing for any skater. It doesn't matter how efficient you are. Here's a look at the triple salchow. That was probably the most coordinated jump that she had in the program. Legs were loose in the air, but the timing was good on the takeoff. There's the double axel. The body got all twisted up there. Look at the rotation position. Let's take a look at the upper arms. Not too bad, but the elbows are up, so they're not down close to the body. That would help. Let's look at the free leg now. Where are the legs in the air? Okay, not too bad. Could be tighter for sure on that one. But here on the double lutz, you'll see this free leg. Yeah, and bending at the waist quite a bit. Just a little bit off balance and collapsing. Like in paraskating, the lady has to be absolutely firm to hold that position as you're lifted. Same thing with single skating. Once you get in the air, you've got to hold tight the position and not let yourself become like a noodle, a little spaghetti. It's got to be firm. And running through programs. I don't know how many programs all the skaters run through, but that's the one thing, first of all, puts you in shape, and it teaches you how to cope under the stress of having to think during a program. So program run-throughs every day, maybe back-to-back, but never go a day, at least when you skate, without doing a program run-through in the competitive season. Absolutely critical. Never stopping. Good to get out here, experience gained, and watching all your other competitors, learning from them. Putting yourself out there to do the best that you can do. I always really believe this sport is so difficult because you're by yourself out there for everyone to see the strengths and the weaknesses. Let's take a look at the scores. Free program for Anna. 46.80, that's fourth so far in the free skate. Total competition score of 76.67, and it currently overall is in fourth place. Clementina, 14 years old, skating to the light of the seven by the Game of Thrones. Well, no question, she's a little disappointed coming off the ice, probably mostly for the fall right at the end. But look, here's the reality. This young lady does not have the same set of skills as many of the other skaters. She came here and did what she could do with the training that she has had, and you saw the focus and concentration on her face. That is the spirit of sport. Everyone can participate. Here's the axel, gets around. She doesn't have the same, perhaps even fitness, the same opportunities. But she had the courage to come here and to test what she can do in competition. To me, and you can see her focus and her concentration. Maybe not a lot of expression for sure, but she's thinking, what's next? What do I have to do? Okay, how do I get my body organized? Because it's not automatic. Hasn't had enough training to make it automatic. There's the double salchow. That was well done. That's what I love about the Junior Grand Prix. The range is huge. They come from all over the world, from rinks that are only for a couple months, for no off-ice program to the Russian and the American off-ice program to everyone's different. And this young lady's courage that it took to come here and skate is equal to that of the top skaters, but with a different set of skills. Wouldn't be here if she didn't like it. Okay, she may not have enjoyed that performance as much. A 27.92 for the free program. The total competition score. A 43.76. Chin up, young lady. Keep doing what you love to do. Keep focus on your own accomplishments. There's a look at the top five so far. Elizabeth, 16 years old. She's coached by Oksana Potokova, and this is her second Junior Grand Prix season, 45.83, personal best week three in Lithuania. And she's skating to music performed by Andrea Bocelli. Well, she looked kind of okay coming off the ice with that. We'll take a look at some of the elements. Just want to have a teaching point on this double axel. Not this one. We'll take a look at the second one here. Watch the back edge. See how it goes inside here and then steps, has to step way outside. But she gets it done, so that's good work on her part. But take a look again. Watch right here. She's a back outside. Good. Now she should just step forward, but she goes back inside, changing the direction and then having hook it around the corner. Now strong enough to get it done. Good for her. But if you take a look at the top double axles, girls or boys, doesn't matter, they keep the same direction all the way. Back outside edge to forward outside edge. Never a hint of a back inside edge. Here's a look at the double Lutz. Hands over the head, up into the double loop. Good work there. And you can see it's quite slow, so it's certainly more momentum, not crazy speed, not wild, but certainly more momentum coming through that. Momentum is energy, and if you apply your jump up to the energy across the ice that you've got through flow, it makes the jump much easier. But, you know, always there's a little fear in the beginning, so you go a little slow, and then you don't have the energy. You're sort of caught in between. Don't want to go too fast, but don't want to go too slow. What's the right speed? And that all comes by feel. Because at this point, we don't measure speed on ice, and we need to. Certainly the technical panel looking at all the jump landings to make sure that they accurately and fairly apply the same call, if you will, throughout the whole competition. That quarter mark landing, so important. Lose so many points if you're under rotated in all your jumps, or many of them. Let's take a look at the score, free program for Elizabeth. Season's best at 50.07. That puts her currently into fourth place in the free program with a total competition score of 72.15. Elizabeth is currently in fifth overall. And a look at the current standings after the first group. Second group taking to the ice right now for the warm-up. I want to take this opportunity to thank all the local volunteers here at the Slovenian Skating Association for helping to host and being so kind to us in hosting this event here in Ljubljana. We love coming to this city and this part of the world. It's a real privilege. And to all the officials, judges, technical panel, travel around the world to give up time, their vacation time, to come here to be in the rink for sometimes 8 hours delivering scores for a sport they also love. We thank them for their time and dedication and expertise as well. The coaches, we thank not only not for what you do for the athletes as skaters, but also helping to guide these young people through life, through difficult times as they grow up. School and skating and all sorts of things that life comes your way. Getting the great support, helping you through times of wonderment and times of confusion, of those people that help guide you on your life path, so important. Coaches do such a wonderful job at that. Veronica, 18 years old, second Junior Grand Prix season, born in Almaty, 61.04. personal best in the free program. And she's skating it this afternoon to the Bloody Mistress by Dmitry Dankov. Well, that was interesting. I found her a little confusing because I would see her aggressive and pushing and gaining speed and accelerating and some good spins. And then I would see her slow rotation and then have to land on 2 feet. So she had moments of, wow, this girl's is good. She's going to go for this. And then moments of just, particularly on the jumps, just the timing not working. So there's something there for sure. Let's take a look. Here's the double axel right off the top. The back edge was better. Nice height on that. That was good. Nice and clean. Euler, double Salchow. So good start to the program. A little bit around the corner. You want to keep it flowing across the ice. Here's a triple Salchow, but this did not lift high enough to get around all the way. 2 foot landing downgraded, in fact, in the judging system. Here's the double axel. Good height there. It's around. Want to cover the ice, cross the ice a bit further, more length to the jump. There's a double loop, single loop. She meant to do a double-double there. Nice sit position. Side variation. Back camel keeps the speed, which was really nice, from one foot to the other. Kept good consistent speed throughout that spin. There's a double flip with 2 feet, you know, just a mistimed takeoff. You can see her expression of disappointment on that. Here's some nice moves later on in the step sequence. Finally, the layback spin. Free program score for Veronica, season's best at 61.90. She's first in the free program with a total competition score of 93.33. Veronica is first overall at this point. There's a look, top five so far. Naya, 17 years old. This is her first Junior Grand Prix season, second competition, 58.80. She earned that in the free program week one in Bratislava. She's coached by Anya and Kaja Otovic, skating her free program to Pearl Harbor by Hans Zimmer. Thank you. Well, nice job by Nea. I love the step sequence. It's beautiful music, Pearl Harbor. It's got a wonderful sort of sweeping feel to it. She had lovely soft knees, worked beautifully with the music. Here's the double axel. She's got a great double axel takeoff. Fabulous mechanics. Too far back on the heel. Free leg got stuck in front. Couldn't get it back. She went down, but we'll see a good one a little bit later. Triple salchow here. Stands up on it, but this is downgraded in 2 foot landing. And the double flip. You can see the free legs a little loose on the double jumps. Here's the second double axel. Look at this. Nice. Hands over the head of the double toe. Great mechanics on the double axel. The arms and the free leg help lift her up in the air. Here's the double Lutz. See the free leg just a little loose. I'm gonna tighten those legs up in the air, make it a little bit more aerodynamical and efficient. But she had a good program here, got most of her elements that she had on her list done right here at home in front of colleagues and clubmates. Exciting to skate in front of your friends. Also, sometimes a little nerve-wracking. Nice job. Free program score. For Nea's season's best at 63.02. Okay, she's going, okay, that's good. That's first in the free program with a 94.98. He is currently overall in first place. Nice job. Kiss from the coach. And now a pitcher. Leona, 16, born in Baka Topola. Third junior Grand Prix season. She's coached by Melissa Stakovic. 56.50 personal best week two in Austria. Skating to El Tango de Roxanne Moulin Rouge. Thank you. Well, the music is aggressive, and so was she, particularly in the first part of the program. She was pushing and accelerating and was fueled by the energy of the music. She fought for a lot of those landings. Look at some of that, and I'll show you a little bit about that free leg. It's okay for doubles. Got to get that down for the triples. Look at that in super slow-mo in just a little bit. Here's a look. There's the triple Salchow. Pretty good conversion into tighter rotation, so she certainly can do that. She can get the legs down. Here's the double axel. Probably a little under-rotated on that, and you can see that legs were not tight in the air, so wasn't that efficient. Here's the double flip. Watch the left leg. It's up there. You can see how it's bent and up. Those 2 feet should be tucked together. Double axel goes way down, gets way up in the air, so that was good. And she needs it because she rotates slow, so she needs to get the height to get around. Here's the double Lutz. Watch. We've gone super slow here. Watch this left leg. The takeoff one right there. See how high it is and how high that skate comes up her leg? Right there. Okay. You can survive on the double, but on the triple, feet stuck together, no space between those legs. And you want to do that on the doubles as well because you're preparing yourself for the triples at that point. It gets a little bit of a habit by having that leg up there. Loss of balance on the switch to the inside edge there on that spin. But I like her aggressiveness. She's strong. She can really get airborne. Just need a little bit more efficiency in what you do up in the air, and that's spin. Season's best, 64.90 for Leona. That's first in the free program with a total competition score of 101.90. A little nod from the coach there. She's currently overall in first place. There's a look at your top five so far. Anadea, 14 years old. First Junior Grand Prix season. Skating her free program here in Ljubljana to Meditation by Massenet. Okay, some very nice work by Anna Day. Got a smile coming off the ice. She fought through a lot of difficult elements. Rotates very quickly. Nice, straight, tight. You can see what we talk about all the time. She has it. In the beginning of the program, she had some weaknesses on the landing, giving it, but then she started to fight back. We'll take a look at some of those elements, but good job here this afternoon. Look how tight she is, how quick she is, just collapsing in the middle part of the body, but after that, she was good. Here's triple toe. Look how straight and tight she is in the air and how quick she is. That's the key. Straight, tight, and quick. Triple loop. Okay, that's downgraded, but the mechanics are there. It'll just take a little bit more strength, a little height, a little quickness. There's a nice camel spin. Difficult variation of the sit. Nicely centered all the way through this. Yeah, very nice. Later in the program, another triple toe loop, maybe a little under, not sure, but still mechanics of the two jump combination, good. And then the triple salchow, this was definitely downgraded, didn't get all the way around. But basically the mechanics of her takeoff, the technique of her takeoffs, very good. Her efficiency in the air, very good, straight, tight, and strong, and quick. She's on her way. As she grows and gets stronger, just gonna get better. Nicely done. Free program score, 63.26. That's second in the free program so far. The total competition score of 96. That puts Anna Dea in currently overall in the second place. Here's a look at the current standings. Ilaida, 19 years old, born in Istanbul. Choreography in the free program by Florent Amodio. Skating here to Scent of a Woman by Thomas Newman. Thank you. Oh, that was a good skate. Strong young lady. She knows where she is in the air, makes the adjustments. Lots of little things to fix up for sure. Everyone has that. But that was a pretty good program. Especially the triple flips. You can see she's not 100% tight and straight in the air, but she's strong enough. Let's take a look. Here's the triple flip. Up, straight, pretty tight. A 2 foot or under rotation of the triple flip, then the double toe. Here's the another triple flip. Look how tight she is there. Yeah, really well done. Doubles get a little looser, but the triple, she's tight. That's awesome. Here's the double axel. Not a lot of flow on the landing, but gets it done. This was an awkward fall here. I think she gets her feet caught up on the landing. They get kind of stuck both there, and the free leg doesn't get out. It goes down hard, but had a good comeback. Look at the double flip. Double loop, double loop. You can see the legs a little looser on that. I want to tighten that up a little bit, but still, well done. There's the flying sit spin variation. Sideways there. Not easy to keep the speed going at the end of that program. Yeah, nice job. Sharp, snappy. Free skating score for Ilada. 63 points for the free program. That's fourth overall in the free with a total competition score of 98.10 that puts Ilada currently into second place overall. Look at your top five so far. One more skater to come before the ice resurfacing. Hannah, 15 years old, first junior Grand Prix season, second event this year, 65.59 personal best in Bratislava week one, skating to La La Land.
Thank you.
Well, good job by Hannah today. I think this was her better performance than her first time out in the Junior Grand Prix, which was fine, but this was well done. That was week one, so she's had lots of time to get back and train and practice and whatnot, and I think we saw the result of that here. There's a look at the triple sow cow. Over-rotated, just didn't get that free leg back in the heel. Free legs got stuck forward. Always happens that way if you're too far back. Here's a look at the triple flip. Good work there all the way around. Just collapsed it. Too bad on that. Triple Salchow. Foot probably slightly under-rotated there. Once again, the efficiency of the rotation position certainly could improve, but she's strong. Look at that. That was nice. A little tight curve on the landing. You want to have that glide out a little bit more. Here's the double flip, double loop. Good. Double axel near the end of the program. Right on top. A little loose on the landing there. Double flip right up into... Mistake on that. So traveling three turns into... change combinations been at the end. It's a level three. Get stronger, getting more efficient. Coach teaches by sight, skater skates by feel. Sometimes what they see and communicate is different when the skater feels. It's always a complicated process. Let's look at the free program score for Hannah. 64.97, that's first in the free program, and with a total competition score of 99.47, Hannah's currently in second place overall after two groups. There's a look at the current standings after two groups. Leona 101.90, Hannah 99.47, Nilada 98.10. Your top three, tree surfacing. We'll be back with group three, the ladies' free program here, week six in Ljubljana. Stay with us.